Hi friends! Welcome to Storytime with the Met. My name is Emily and I'm so glad that you've joined me. While the museum is closed, we're holding Storytime online every Thursday at noon. Today, we're going to read a story, take a look at a work of art, and then go over a project you can do together at home. Are you ready? Okay, we'll find a cozy spot. We are going to start with our Storytime song, just like we do when we're together at the museum. It goes to the tune of This Old Man. You can sing and clap along with me. Ready? One, two, three. Welcome, friends, get ready, get set for Storytime with the Met, where we love to read and sing and look at works of art and picture books. We'll use our eyes to look and see. We'll use our ears to hear stories. Now let's take a seat and give a shh. Let's begin with our first book. Very nice job. Our book today is called Mr. Tiger Goes Wild by Peter Brown. Are you ready? I am going to read the words and I need your help looking at the pictures. Mr. Tiger Goes Wild. Everyone was perfectly fine with the way things were. Everyone but Mr. Tiger. Mr. Tiger was bored with always being so proper. Good day, Mr. Tiger. Good day, Mr. Deer. Lovely weather we are having, I suppose. Indeed. Now, children, please do not act like wild animals. He wanted to loosen up. He wanted to have fun. He wanted to be wild. And then one day, Mr. Tiger had a very wild idea. Look at his body. How is he standing now? On all fours. He felt better already. Mr. Tiger became wilder and wilder each day. Look at him sitting on that bench. What does he say? Can you say it with me? Roar. Nice job. His friends did not know what to think. Peculiar. Wow. Unacceptable. And then, Mr. Tiger went a little too far. Look at him now. I think he looks rather regal. His friends have lost their patience. Mr. Tiger, if you must act wild, kindly do so in the wilderness. What a magnificent idea! So Mr. Tiger ran away. Where is he going? Going into the wilderness? Let's see. Into the wilderness. What do you notice? Where he went completely wild. Can you give another roar, just like Mr. Tiger? Roar. But Mr. Tiger was lonely. He missed his friends. He missed the city. He missed his home. Take a look. Can you see the city in the background? So, Mr. Tiger decided to return. And he found that things were beginning to change. I see more animals on all fours. And now Mr. Tiger felt free to be himself. His new shirt. And so did everyone else. The end. Thank you for reading along with me, friends. This book makes me think about a painting in the museum by an artist named Antoine-Louis Barye, a royal tiger. Take a look. What do you notice? Mr. Barye would go to the menagerie or the zoo in Paris and sketch and paint different kinds of animals to study them, just like this tiger. What words would you use to describe this tiger? Is he relaxed? Is he alert? Is he playful? Is he sneaky? What words would you use? If you were going to create a painting or a picture of a tiger, how would you have him posed? Would he be relaxed like this, lying down? Or would he be about to pounce? What do you notice about the habitat that the tiger is in? The background that we see where he lives? Looks like it could be his natural habitat, right? In our story, Mr. Tiger went from the city to the wilderness, right? To the jungle that may be more like his natural habitat. And we are going to create an animal collage today. I'm going to show you some different materials and talk about how you can do this at home, where you can think about what habitat your animal could live in. Ready? Okay, so let's see, I've got some supplies here. The first thing I needed were some pictures of animals. So I looked in a magazine to find some animals to cut out and collage into my work of art. You could also use a photograph or print out a picture to use. So here, I found a picture of a kangaroo. Which means I also need my scissors. I needed a glue stick to glue my pieces of my collage together. And I used some different kinds of animal print paper as well. You can use plain color paper if you want. And I also printed out a picture of a habitat, a different kind of habitat. Now mine's a little bit silly. So this one, I found a picture of a zebra. I cut him out, and instead of putting him in his natural habitat, do you see what background I used? I made him in the city, just like we found Mr. Tiger. And I put some strips of paper all around to make my collage, and I glued it just on a plain piece of construction paper. So, I can't wait to see what you make and which kind of habitat you create for your creature. Well, friends, thanks for joining me for Storytime with the Met. It was nice to see all of you, and we hope to see you again soon. Bye!